folks like you who are willing on a Friday night to come up in a challenging circumstance, and for the most part, you gotta get past a minute to make your pitch and try to attract somebody with your idea, your chutzpah, your energy, that you've got something to make our lives better. And you know, really is an extraordinary time. We're living in a world where, and this is data that's 15 years old, that, you know, there's more knowledge in a basic computer than all of the encyclopedias of knowledge combined prior to 1850. So how do we recognize, whether it's technology change or product changes, or the ideas of cakes or nursing, you know, how do we think about innovation in a way, and how those of us who are in policy making positions can actually help, is really a challenge, because most of the folks I work with, part of the party, have never started anything. You know, one of the major differences between people have asked me between business and politics. In business, you're measured every year by actually what you get done. You have a balance sheet, you may have a competitor, but you know, you can't run a business if all you do is run down your competition and you don't put out a good product yourself. Mm-hmm. The remarkable thing about politics in America today is there are many people, again, in both political parties, who spend their whole career doing nothing more than running down the opposition and never putting out a good product themselves.
Mm-hmm.
And that has led to, as you probably said, the appearance of dysfunction. On a good news standpoint, there are certain things that I think that are coming about that could change it. One is, we do have to get our nation's balance sheet in order. Again, that's a policy item. I'm not going to need 9 days out of a campaign. Unless anybody asks, I won't launch on that. But in a global economy, in a knowledge-based economy, what does it really come down to? Who are going to be the areas? Who are going to be the communities? Who are going to be the countries that are going to be successful? To my mind, it comes down, when you cut away all the politics and you cut away all the other policy issues, it comes down to a competition for access to capital and access to talent. Frankly, as